Good morning, Andy. Here we are going to discuss about the thyristor. So, thyristor denotes is a family of semiconductor devices which are used for power control. Okay, which are used for power control in DC and AC systems. Okay, in DC and AC systems. Here the oldest member of the family is SCR, silicon controlled rectifier. That means here, putting by thyristor denotes a family of the semiconductor device. Means what is the family? Means TIAC, DIAC, silicon control switch and programmable UE junction transistor and GTO and RCT, all these comes under family of the semiconductor devices. So here thyristor is the name came from combination of the two terms, that means thyristor plus transistor. That means by combining these two terms, okay, by combining these two terms, so the thyristor name, okay, and its prototype was introduced by General Electrical Company USA in 1957, and after that International Electrotechnical Commission in 1963, the final decision has been taken on that one. And it consists of three or more p-n junctions, and it will be having the two stable states, one is on state and off state. And coming to next topic is here terminal characteristics of the thyristors. That means here it will be having the four layer means here p n. Terminals are anode and cathode and gate. Here junctions are j1, j2 and j3. Here thyristor is a 4-layer 3-junction PNPN semiconductor switching device. It will be having the anode, cathode and gate. Here the gate terminal, you can observe that gate terminal is usually kept near the cathode terminal. The terminal connected to outer P region, okay, the terminal connected to outer P region is called anode, and the terminal connected to outer N region is called cathode, and the terminal connected to outer P region, inner P region and the outer N region is called our gate terminal. And it here the voltage ratings are 10 kilo ohms and RMS current rating is 3000 amperes and power rating is 30 megawatts. You can observe. These are the basic discussion about our thyristor. And next one is the symbol. Symbols will be of like this. Here one symbol will be there. Here it is a plus, okay, gate. Here this is the anode terminal and cathode terminal. And of course one more symbol also you can use. Here the one more symbol is like this also you can use. Okay, these are the two symbols which we will use for the in order to represent the thyristor. And of course here silicon control rectifier, it can be called so called. Why? Because here we will use the silicon, okay, we will use the silicon for its construction and its operation as a rectifier. That means for the both construction and operation of the rectifier we will use the silicon. So that's why silicon control rectifier. And one more thing, why it will be controlled name means here it will be having the very low resistance, okay, very low resistance in the case of the forward conduction and very high resistance in the case of the reverse direction. So that's why it can be called as a controlled device. And next one we will go for our static VI characteristics of the thyristors. So for coming to the static VI characteristics, here this is the circuit symbol. In this circuit symbol you can observe there is a potential divider and there is a anode and a cathode and gate will be there. there will be of the three modes will be the first mode is reverse blacking mode, and the second one is forward blacking mode, and third one is forward conduction mode. So with respect to all these things we will discuss our discussion. That means whenever you are going with respect to the construction and with respect to characteristics, here first we will see the characteristics. So with respect to characteristics, here these are the characteristics you can observe. So in the reverse blacking mode, first one is in the reverse blacking mode, when the cathode is made positive with respect to the anode, okay, when the cathode is made positive with respect to the anode, then what is happening we will see now. So what he is mentioning means here, when the cathode is made positive with respect to the anode, then the switch will be open, then automatically thyristor is reverse biased as shown in the figure. And next, what about the junctions? Junctions G1 and G3 are said to be reverse biased, whereas the junction J2 is forward biased. That means here a small leakage current of the order of, here you can observe, a small leakage current of the order of few milliamperes will be going, and this is called as a reverse blacking mode. In this reverse blacking mode, the thyristor will be called as a off state, that means it is the open switch. Here you can observe the reverse leakage current. After the reverse leakage current, you may observe VBR. That means as the, if the reverse voltage is increased, then at a critical breakdown level, a reverse breakdown voltage VBR, okay, reverse breakdown voltage VBR you can get. That means an avalanche occurred between J1 and J3, so that automatically the reverse current will be increased here. In the, that means finally what we are going to say is, when the reverse voltage is applied across a thyristor which is less than VBR, the device offers a high impedance in the reverse direction. So the SCR in the reverse blacking mode may therefore be treated as open switch. And coming to the next one is forward blacking mode. Okay, forward blacking mode. In the case of the forward blacking mode, when the anode is positive with respect to the cathode with the gate circuit open, then the thyristor is said to be forward biased. Then automatically J1 and J3 are forward biased, but the junction J2 is a reverse biased. So that means here you can observe OM. Okay, here OM will represent forward blacking mode of the SCR. As the forward leakage current is small, SCR offers a higher impedance. Therefore, thyristor can be treated as an open switch even in the forward blacking mode. That means in the reverse blacking mode also it will be open switch. In the forward blacking mode also it is treated as the open switch. Next, coming to our next one is forward conduction mode. When the anode to the cathode forward voltage is increased with respect to the gate circuit open, then the reverse biased junction J2 will be having an avalanche breakdown at a voltage called forward breakover voltage. That means here also we are getting one more voltage, that is nothing but VBO, forward breakover voltage. That means here at a voltage avalanche will be occurred in the case of the forward direction. And what is happening after this breakdown, thyristor will be turned on with point M. At once it is from M point to it is shifting to N point. At a time it will be shifted from M point to N point, then to a point anywhere between N to K. That means N to K here you can observe. That means here NK will represent, here this region will represent the forward conduction mode. Forward conduction mode you can observe. And next, here simply a thyristor can be brought from forward blacking mode to the forward conduction mode by turning it on by applying a positive gate pulse between the gate and the cathode. First one is a positive gate pulse, okay, by means of a positive gate pulse. And next one is a forward breakover voltage. Forward breakover voltage also will be applied. That means forward blanking mode 2, it should be connecting to forward connection mode. Then this is the operation. In this one you can observe, okay, in this one you can observe there is a latching current and holding current will be there. What are the definitions of this latching current means? It is defined as the latching current means, latching current, what is meant by latching current? Latching current means it is defined as the minimum value of the anode current which it must attain during the turn on process to maintain the conduction when the gate signal is removed. That means here this is the latching current. Then what is meant by latching current means the minimum value of the anode current which it must attain during the turn on process to maintain the conduction. To maintain the conduction, it has to maintain some current. That current is called as a latching current. And its holding current means it is defined as the minimum value of the anode current below which SCR can get turned off. Okay, SCR, SCIH means below which the SCR can turn off is called as a holding current. In general, latching current IL is greater than the IH. So here this is the class for today. Thank you.